Hey pretty face, welcome back again to my YouTube channel. My name is Lady Sharon. For those of you who are watching me for the first time, thank you so much guys for watching. My returning subscribers, I appreciate every one of you. And to those of you who recently subscribed to my channel, I welcome you into my YouTube family as well. So guys, in today's video I'm sharing with you how I customize my simple low budget manicure head for making my wig cap. Okay, so this is very simple to make an affordable bouquet. Instead of you going to buy expensive manicure hair just to make your cute wig cap, just sit back and watch this tutorial before making a purchase. Okay, so yes, before I ever started making my videos on YouTube, I bought two manicure head, okay, which I didn't supposed to buy. Okay, so the first ever one I bought was this canvas right here. Okay, this one size is just 24. Yes, so the problem with this one is it doesn't have a face, so you don't actually, you can't tell where to start from the frontal hairline and all that. And also the size of the hair, sometimes you can just buy the one that is too small or too big, too large for your hair adjustable wig net. Okay, so yes, after using this one to make my first ever wig cap, after wearing it for 1 month, I was having problem with the elastic band. Okay, after wearing it for a few months, like I was having space between my own head and the wig cap, it was too much because the band was no more intact. Yeah, it was too slack. Okay, that's because of the hair circumference. It stretches out the elastic band before even I ever finish making the wig cap. That is for that. So yes, I just keep that aside and I place an order for another one. This one came. This one is beautiful, no doubt. There is a face on it, but the problem with this one is the head is too small. Okay, it's not the same size as my own head circumference. You can see if you look closely, the net, I see have some extra nets from the mannequin head, which indicate it's not the same size as my own head. And whenever I'm using this mannequin to make my wig cap, I always ended up adjusting it and then using my T-pin to secure it before crocheting my hair or whatever I'm doing on the net. Okay, that is it for that. So instead of me to buy this expensive things, like this one cost me $40. Okay, so if you're using a good quality manicure, it's going to cost you from $40 and above. So instead of me to place an order again to buy one or to customize one for myself, which I know after buying it I'm still going to find some errors somewhere, you understand? So I thought to myself, it's better for me to just make one for myself instead of me placing an order and having the same mistake repeat itself. Okay, that is where I went out and I bought some items. So I bought this styrofoam. Okay, I bought the styrofoam mannequin head. This cost me just €3.99. So this is the pack it came with. Okay, so this is the pack. I saved this pack so you can see the price clearly. So this is €3.99. okay, that is it for that. So after buying this, I also bought my drainage mat. So this is the mat right here. So if you watch closely, you will see it is made for the kitchen purpose. Yes, and this one cost me just €1.59, which is very good. So the quality of this is a foam as well. So when you press it and you release your hand, you see it's going to just bounce back to the original size, and you can actually maneuver it, like squeeze it and you release your hand, and it's going to just go back to the original size as well. So after buying this, I also bought one more thing, which is the tape I use in sealing the mat and the mannequin stereo together. So this tape is the dual tape, which is the all-purpose tape, which is very good in case you're using it to bind the mat and the mannequin together. If eventually it ties up, like it's squeezed together, you can just open it, which is very easy to make. So this one is not recommended. If you're using something like this, we all know this one, if it closes, it's very difficult to open. So make sure not to use something like this. And it also is very thin. It can easily break as well. So don't use something like this. Instead, get something like this. So this one cost me, this is the smaller size. Okay, this one cost me just €4. Yes, so if you are buying a double of this one, which is €8, you can buy this one from online store, or you can, yeah, you can buy it from any building shop where they sell building things they use in building houses. So just go there and then get something like this. This is very strong and yeah, and good for making your mannequin head. So that is it for that. So guys, I used something else I didn't buy. So I had a tape, measuring tape right here. So if you don't have a measuring tape, you can then go to your local shop and then get one for yourself. It's very cheap, I think €1 or so. So what I did with this one was to take a measurement from my own hair circumference, just like this, and I wrote it down in a piece of paper. I also took a measurement from my frontal hairline to the back through the crown, just like this, okay, to the back side as well, like this. And I also wrote it down. So I use the measurement in making my own customized maniki head, which is this one, and it came out so perfect. Never mind the it's not too neat or it's not too beautiful or cute, but it's worth it, guys. It's worth it, okay? So instead of me to go ahead and place an order, customize here and there, what I know is not going to be the best for me, it's better for me to spend lesser money, make my own that is perfect and cute, than buying something that is beautiful fashion with makeup and eyelashes and all that, and at the end it doesn't worth it, okay? So what do you think about this, my cute maniki head right here? So do you think it's okay or you think it is wrong? So let me know in the comment section. So let's do the calculation. This one is €1.59, yes, and the tape is €4, and my maniki stero is €3.99. So you do the calculation, how much you think it is, okay? So instead of you to buy cheaper things or expensive things like this, so it depends on what you want. You can go for this or you go for this. So for me, from now on, no more buying of maniki head, guys. So I'll always stick to things like this that I know is best for me, okay, guys? So yeah, that is it for that, guys. So just enjoy watching the video, and after watching the video, if you like my video, if you like my tutorial, don't forget to give me a like to my video, okay? Because it's very, very important when it comes to my channel, okay? And also don't forget to subscribe, and after subscribing, turn on the bell, okay? Because if you don't turn on the bell, next time when I'm having a cute video concerning my hair routine and all that, or my next new video concerning my wig, you will not get notification. So try to always turn on the notification bell, okay, guys? So see you later after finishing watching the video. So take care and have a nice day. See you later, guys. Bye. All right, pretty. So this is how I make my own customized maniki hair. So first thing I did was to just take my measuring tape and then measure out my own hair cycle fronts, which is the area which I'll be working with, and then go ahead and start laying the mat on the maniki. So you can see the maniki head is not kind of floppy on both sides, which is the ear area, okay? So I cut my own mat into two different sizes. I want first size, which is this one I'm working with, is longer than the other ones, which I'll be laying later on, and then use my own tape to just lay it there just to secure it. You can see what I'm talking about. I can easily peel off the tape and then lay it back again just to smoothen everything up. So this is the other part I'm going to be working with. So I'm just laying it on the ear side of the other side, and then use my my tape again to secure it properly to the maniki head while I work on the other side, which is the crown. But before working on the crown, I'm just going to just use my measuring tape again to just measure out the crown from the frontal hairline to the back, which is the neck, and then use my biro to just point it out to the point where I want the cap or the maniki head to stop, okay? So yes, I'm just going to just continue laying the mat on the maniki and then using my tape to secure it until I am done with everything. Dancing on the moon. Maybe my compass was wrong, and I'm still on my way. Lost at least to where I belong. I'm still rolling the dice, praying. Alright friends, so after sealing up the back side, which is the neck area, I'm going to just use my tape once again to just seal it up from edge to the other side of the edge, okay? So I'm doing this just to seal up everything together. So while I was getting to the other part of the end part, so the tape was like sticking together, so I just had to just use my scissors right there to just cut it, and then use my fingers to open it before laying it flat again on the maniki. So this is the reason why you have to buy this tape, okay? It's very easy to manipulate when you want to make maniki head like this, okay? So this is very simple. So I'll be working my way on the crown and then come back to show you guys.
So here is my mannequin head after padding the crown. So it's still not fitting in properly into my own head measurement, okay? So I'm laying my mat once again on the crown and then use my tape to just to secure it one more time. So I'll be doing the same thing with the back side, okay? So yes, at the middle part of the mat, you can see it's pulling up and I wanted it to be really flat, like to lay it really flat right there. So I'm using my scissors to just cut it at that point. So I'll be doing the same thing to the other side as well. So to make sure everything is really flat, it's still not really flat after cutting it, so I just had to just trim it at one edge, okay, just like that. So after trimming it, I just had to just press everything really tight into the crown before using my tape to secure it properly, okay guys. So I'll just be doing this and I'll be working my way to the other side. Just keep watching as I'll be right back. So here is my crown after laying the double layer. So at this point, I'm using the leftover piece of my mat to just cover up any space at the back side, okay, just to make sure everything fits in properly into my head circumference, guys. So this is very easy. So after doing this, I'll be taking the measurement from my frontal hairline down to the back where I have the point, just to see if everything is okay. Okay, so yes, everything was fine. So this is the end part. So I'm using my tape to just seal up everything, just to cover up those spaces you are seeing right there, and just to cover the mat as well, that way I don't have to see the color, that gray color of the mat, okay, and to make it a little bit beautiful and to secure it properly. So when you're doing this, make sure you're really pulling the tape, like you're really pulling it very well, just to make it really tight, okay. You can see this is it. Everything is really perfect. This is so simple to make, so you can just go ahead and then make one for yourself, okay. Just give it a try. There is no harm in trying, okay? Like they said, practice make perfect. Just do it yourself and you will really love it. So here is the mannequin head after everything. So once again, I'm using my measuring tape to just measure out the head circumference, just to make sure I'm in the right direction, okay? So everything was fine as usual. So it's time for me to just try my wig net on my new mannequin head, just to see if everything will fit in properly, okay. So yes, you can see everything is okay, everything was perfect. So all I had to do whenever I want to make new wig is just to use my T-pin to just secure it at the edges, okay, that way it doesn't pull off when I'm making or when I'm crocheting my wig, okay. That is it, guys. You can see everything is okay. There is no extra lace material hanging up from somewhere. Everything is just perfect and on point. So yeah, I just had to just try this one more time so you can see what I'm talking, okay. So this is it, guys. Everything is so perfect. Just go ahead and then do one for yourself. Yes, so yes, after trying the third one, which was also perfect for my new mannequin hair, so I'll be trying the old mannequin just to show you guys the difference between this new one I just made and the old one, okay. So this is the most fashionable mannequin you guys always buy online, or we all buy from online stores. So this is it. We will never get our own hair circumference, no matter the size we buy, okay. So this is it, guys. So thank you for watching. If you like my video, if you like my tutorial, don't hesitate to thumbs up, like this video, because it's very important for my YouTube channel. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification bell for you to get the next update from me. Thank you so much, and I will see you again. Take care and have a nice day. Bye.